when Jesus died on the cross, everything was open. This song that came out, that you guys will be dancing, will be playing like this. No, no, sir, I don't finish. You finish your life.
Jehovah, whatever you call him, that you like him, who puts his throat like that, who can dress.
This is tattoo. Who started it? It's not from movie. People from movie started tattoo. It's a demon. 666. In case you have it now, a victim of FIA. Get ready. Go grab tattoo beast in your body. Say you're a nigga. You're a nigga. A girl, that tattoo in your body. Anybody who sees you like the tattoo, you thought it's not normal. What is tattoo doing in your body? Tattoo. Do you know that thing has prevented men not to marry green men? A green man cannot marry a tattoo woman now. But you want to carry two people for her. I come from you, tattoo is another person. You have a woman sleeping on your bed. You have seen two people, tattoo and woman. Which one will you not take? Is it tattoo? Put tattoo, a big man. Oh my man, who put in the middle of the baby? Is it this tattoo or this there? I don't know that it's confusing you. You want to talk to one person, you are sitting this. Which one I will talk to? Now this girl talk to tattoo. Go, help me. You just see the tattoo here, don't they do like this? Some of you, you don't want to have your shame. Some of you will not be very close and will cover it, you will still expose it. You will stay longer than you expected though. Men will be so scarce, they will run. Only Agbero will come. Because only Agbero will marry a woman who carry tattoo here. Carry for here. He don't do you. Go carry for here. When you open your body for a man to put that tattoo here, you were not ashamed. You know how many demons you have in your body? All the tattoo in your body, they are symbols of evil. Symbols. Call them fancy. Star. I'm a big girl. Don't worry. We shall know who we talk about. Whether you are a big girl or not. Share some of our sisters who have big tattoo in their body. No husband. They are castle. They are money. They will be begging you, young man. Say, man, I will give you 2 million. The young man will say, I'm looking for to keep. The lady will be saying, I'm not saying you marry me free. I'm even telling now, I will give you 3 million with a new G. Rado G. I tell you some more time. She's beautiful. She has a house. And no husband. Number 7. Because of time. Is it fine? True parents. True what? Number 6. True divorce and remarriage. True divorce and what? Remarriage. Number 8. Number 7. True association. True the association. People you work with. People you associate with. Number 8. True television. Number 9. True books. True what? Books. Be careful the kind of books you read. The kind of what? Books you read. Some of us say, go. You know all those naked pictures, books. Eh? That's what we have. When a girl and a man got naked, they will tell you everything about sex life. That's what. Why do you think you will read something from the book about sex life, you will sleep at night, you will see a fair lady coming to make love for you? Are you with me here? Many people God possess, not because a water spirit God that possessed. Because they read a kind of book that had a kind of negative effect on them. Am I talking to somebody here? So be careful of the kind of books you read. Be careful. And the people you move with. Be careful. The Bible says, see that one with the company of the wise. shall be what? In the world with the company of fools shall be destroyed. Show me your sign, I will tell you that. Now, when you get home, tomorrow give you assignment. Take a book and a pen when you get home. You will write. That's what I call God taught me. God showed me something. And I called it entry point. Entry what? You know, everything you are going through now, has an entry point. Now, has what? An entry point. Number one, if you are going to stop what is bothering you, what you are going through now, when you get to, you are going to find out how many girls have I dated so far. Peace. How many girls? This is a serious matter. How many girls have I what? Dated so far. How many guys have I dated so far? And that's number two. What age? Are you hearing me now? This is very important too. So that how this money I pray for you will work. What age? Some of you were 30, 40. Even some of you said you were 7 and a half. Am I talking to somebody here? Huh? Go and find out. Number three. The first person that you met in life, the first person that ever come your way, who was he? I don't know if I'm getting it. Was he a Christian? Was he an occult man? A native doctor? Was he a man with a good heart? On what occasion you guys met? Take note of this. Do you know what I did today? What I'm teaching now, I did a kind of a serious research today. I did my, I took a pen, and the pastor said the truth too. I don't like to tell her. What I did tell you is what I do. What I don't do, I don't teach you. Are you getting me now? I took a pen and a Bible. Because I discovered that there are times we say we don't want to do this thing. We don't want to do this thing again. At the end of the day, you see yourself fall back to that the same thing. Are you not surprised? That means if there is anybody like that, anytime you take a decision not to do a particular thing, and you see yourself fall back to that stuff, meaning that there is a spirit that lives within you. You got it from somewhere. If you cannot trace it, do you know when I was tracing some of the things in my past today? When I was tracing them. As I tried to trace this out, I got to a point to a particular house. I was looking for somebody up to date. Up to now, as I'm talking, the person refused to show up in the spirit. You hear what I said? Every other thing I was looking for, I got there. Then one person refused to show up. Identity, all the identity, everything about that stuff, about that house, everything, they swallowed it. I can't remember any single thing. This is a place I live, a place I know. I can't remember any single thing. Then I'm asking the Lord said, because the person you are trying to do a search of, he said, the person is a very strong person in the spirit. He knows you are searching. That the further information you are about to get will help you to be loose. Oh God. Are you getting what I'm saying here?
Yes,
you must say, hey, Pastor, it's like you are talking to me. Hear this, sir. Do you know for the fact you are married, there are some of you, for the fact you are married, there are things you dated in the past. Even not the man. That's why you don't have anything to do with them again. Everything about them is still fresh in your brain and still, you are still dating. Are you with me here?
Yes,
what? Do you think because of what you have with them, you slept with them before? No. There was a deposit. Why the amount that keep reflecting in your presence is not because You love them in the past. It's because there is something they left behind within you that anytime you see that, that thing reflects within you. Are you with me here? Can I say something here? There are some women. They married for more than 2 to 3, 4, 5 years. They just woke up a day, they said to their husband, I'm no longer interested. And they are ready to leave the marriage, quit the marriage, go back to their former friend. Do you know what happened? It's not that the man they married is not good enough, he's not rich, he's not taking good care of them. But that other guy had a very, very strong hold on them. Are you with me? There are some sisters looking at me now. As far as life is concerned, if you don't disconnect, if you don't pray and disconnect and find out the truth of what I'm telling you today, it'll be very hard for you to stay with one man. It'll be very hard. Because the last man you met who slept with you, before he met you, he had slept with more than 40 girls. The day he slept with you, you completed the circle that make it 40. Are you getting me now? What he put in you was the spirit of 40 years. And some of those girls, some of them have no problem. Some of them, they are from the water world. Some of them, they are candidates of failures. Some of them, nothing is working, disabled, and all that around them. So when the man has been carrying that, so as he goes inside you, everything he carried, transfer. That is why we can pray for you on Monday, you manifest a different spirit. Next other week you come, another person talks in you. I don't know if I'm getting this, sir. They manifest based on the category and the powers deposited inside of you. You say this girl manifested this week. Why is she still manifested the other week? What spoke last week? It's not the same thing that is manifesting this week. Different things were deposited inside you from different angles and different occasions and different places. I'm talking to somebody. Are you with me here? That is why you must be very careful. Even some of the hotel you enter, you say, I pay. You pay for hotel. You say, my money, I pay. Who is the owner of the hotel? Who was the last person that slept in that bed you are about to sleep? What happened on that bed before you came? What do you know that happened between the man and the woman that was brought on that bed? You can sleep on the same bed. Fully when you pay, but some people will tell you how you want a man water. Say what you pay for, you can never be rich. It's not true. You can't be rich because you pay for something. It's not true. And I rent, they will leave you, you pay. You can even use your money to buy something, they will spoil it. I think you know that. So I took a note of this and I discovered something. Now some of you, money doesn't stay in your hand. Money doesn't stay in your hand. The money comes now. The next thing that will come to your mind is what you can spend the money. Where to go. You were not like that before. There was a man you met. There was a girl you met who came to your life. Who introduced that stuff inside you. I mean, I'm getting this out. Are you with me right now? If you see yourself, you suddenly become violent. You are violent. You can talk to everybody, anyhow, anywhere, anytime. You were not like that before. Ask yourself some simple question today. When exactly, which day, which week, which month did this spirit, this very particular spirit, came into my life? Which week, where, which occasion? I don't even get it. You will find out the truth. You will know. That it was this day I met so person. It was this day I went to so place that this is happening. You will know. You will understand. Am I talking to somebody here? Can I say something before we pray? If our children are very loyal and very obedient to you, and there's all of a sudden suddenly associate yourself with people, children around your vicinity who are disobedient, arrogant, what happened to them? Talk to me. What happened to them? They contact the same spirit. See what I'm talking to? See? If you have a man now who talks to his wife anyhow, and you visit this man every day, and you are not that kind of person, do you know that you will learn from that man? You will go back and start talking to your wife anyhow. That's why you must be very careful. You say, I know nothing can happen. I'm a child of God. 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 Even when Judah lost it within him, that this man, Jesus, I'm going to betray him, he never embarked on that journey, never concluded within him until he met with the Roman soldiers. The first time he sat with them, he heard them. And those guys, they have been looking for a list to capture this man. And when he heard them discuss, he said, this one I've been looking for. They helped him to complete his work, his desires. You can have a good, something that is not good in your mind, and you don't want to execute it. Meeting the wrong person will help you to execute it. Be careful. Be careful. I see so many beautiful sisters in the church everywhere. You go to everywhere, you see sisters. There are much more than men in the church. I'm asking you to go, why are they not married? The Lord said, there are many things you don't know that they know. That even prayer cannot help them. Except they sincerely, genuinely sit down and trash them out. When I'm done now, when I'm done with this service time, I'm not leaving your time. I'm going to the mountain. I want to settle my own. Don't play. Don't play. If you don't deal with those things, I'm telling you now, your children will become a victim. I'm not talking to somebody here. The easiest way for children to be contaminated is through their parents. If a man is a 419, you give birth to children with the blood of a 419, automatically he's transferred. That child don't need to learn how to be a 419. By birth, he's 419. Am I talking to somebody? Yeah. By birth! You say, who taught you how to lie? It's in the door. Who taught you how to collect soup? Take fish from the soup. It's in the blood. That is why you must purify yourself. You must ask God. You know the prayer I'm praying, the one you're going to pray today. All those entry points, the entry one, points. This church, I think you see entry points. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's assume we have doors in all the entry points. If you cover them, you lock them up, can you pass? Huh? That means what is affecting you, what is killing you, has an entrance. Do you know why you are still affected now? Do you know why you are still going to pain now? Eh? Because they are still inside. They've not gone through the exit to go back to where they came from. Do you know exit? A way out. Are you getting me now?
Yes,
now, if you are into my teaching, to what I've taught you so far today, I'm not shouting. And this, and try to open your eyes to the truth. Begin to look at yourself. The places you visited, when they ask you to kneel down, they should pray for you. When they ask you to say some cantation, begin to imagine, begin to think. The last place you went, after you visited, you came back, you had a dream, see yourself back the same place. Think. A lady you met in the club, you danced, you took her in and slept with her. The next you never see her again. Think. Ever since your experiences, ever since then, think about them. Can you have another wine inside a bottle? Very old wine inside a bottle. And you take another new wine and you want to put them together to have a better taste? Huh? To have a better taste? What are you going to have? It's our crystal. So it's not possible. So if things are going to change, you have 95% a work, very vital work to do. Serious one. And this will help you. You know what I'm praying for me? I'm a very calm person. Today I stand and I was looking at my life and some things. I said, lately, I don't think that there are things I did lately that are not normal. Maybe violent. Talk to people anyhow or something. I began to do a kind of research. And I began to ask myself, which person? Who was the person? Who was the man, the woman? Who was which occasion? Have I suddenly contacted this for? And my eyes of understanding opened. There are some pastors who came into my life. Pastor we met. Eh? I never accepted them. But when I opened up my spirit to accept them, along the line today I discovered that there's something I got from them that is negative. I was not in my ministry. Are you forgetting me? It takes a man. What I'm telling you now, if you can't do this thing I'm telling you now, very soon you'll be publicly disgraced. You become a what a laughing stock. Remember, before now, you have 2 to 3 abortions. I'm talking to a lady. Talking to a lady, your sister. You have 3 abortions before now. 3 abortions. 3. Maybe God said you are going to have 2. Or you are going to have 3 and 3 children or 4 children. And then you've aborted 3, remaining 1. Do you think that if time comes tomorrow, you get married, you now have only 1 child, no another one, you pray, fast, anything happen? You call Satan, it's not Satan. You settle it now. What happened? Who was the man that got to pregnant the first time? The second one? Is it the same person or different people? Then if it is different people, the person who got to pregnant the first time is different from the second person and third person, you should know that there's a spirit that's about to play a role in your life. What is the spirit? If that spirit materializes and it starts working, it's going to be the spirit of marry and remarry. Are you getting what I'm saying? Am I teaching something here at all? I want to open your eyes to some secrets. When I was, before I gave birth to my baby, before she came at all, God showed me in my vision twice. When she came, when she comes, the things she's going to do, God showed me. When she grew up, when I see her growing up, I started behaving exactly what God showed me. The time I will see that, I will be laughing. I will be laughing. Because I saw everything. Do you know what I'm trying to tell you? Look at this. There are things that are happening around you now. If you can trace them, and identify the time and the locations they came from, your problem will be over. As you don't even need much prayer, the problem will be over. Because there are deaths, there are people, there are events that took place in the past that are still having fresh, as if they are still so very fresh to you. Anytime you see that, you see them playing again and again and again, as if they are just happening now. Am I talking to somebody here? This will help you to zip up, close yourself, or anything negative. I made up my mind, if somewhere program, you can't see me anywhere. I'm not in my house, I travel. If I don't travel, I'm in my prayer room or in the church. Why? Because they are in the atmosphere. So many things. Imagine after this powerful message you receive today, you go back home, a friend will come and tell you about a young girl he just saw today, a young girl I just talked to today, he agreed, I will bring the girl to your house, I want to sleep with the girl. Do you know, brother, you have to be corrupted? Am I talking to somebody here? You will forget the message you receive. Go back home and listen to them again and again and again. You enter into prayer. Everything around you will be hot. No, Kogel. I listen to Kogel. You make up your mind. I don't want to see God. I don't want to sin against you. And you are coming out of the house on your way to the school or work. You now see a bed and never half meter. Look out to the hill where your hair coming from. Remove your eyes. So if you say, God, I told you I'm not going to sin. Now that this girl show up like this, what do I do? You know, because thank God. You know they're there. Now you know what you want your eyes to tell you. As far as I'm concerned, take your eyes off. Bro, somebody say fine. So you have been sitting, rise up, lift up your hands above your head, wave your hands to Jesus. Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. When you get home, remember what I told you. Look, please don't miss our Sunday service. It's serious. By the grace of God, we'll be doing something here on Sunday also too. For 2 to 3 weeks, God said, I'm going to handle this for 4 weeks. 4 weeks. By next week, I'm going to do screening. I'm going to do what? Screening. I'm going to, some persons who need attention. Some persons need attention. If you need deliverance, you need attention from the church or pastor or something, just go and meet pastor. Father, we worship you. We give you praise. We bless your holy name. Is your king with you? Lift it up. Lift that key up above your head. Be fast, no time. I want to leave here before 2:30. Lift it up. In Jesus' name. This is what I'm going to do. After this prayer, look for where to hug the key. Where to what? Just hug it or touch it. Hug it where nobody can touch it. I'm going to give you further instruction on Sunday, the upper week, what to do. Don't touch it. Some of you, some mysteries. By the grace of God, God is going to unravel some mysteries to you. God is going to open some things. We'll show you things are happening around you. Are you hearing me now? Angels are here. Lift up your hands. Back it up. You are going to pray. You are going to say, Father, whatever the enemy used a padlock to lock in my life, lock up in my life and destiny, my marriage, my marital life, my finance, the life of my children, my business, as I lift up this key above my head, I command you force of darkness, I command you powers of the enemy, by the Spirit of God, through this key in my hand, I command you be open. Open your mouth and begin to pray. 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 Open your mouth and begin to pray.
You are going to pray with his key in my hand. My destiny is not for sale. With this key in my hand, I did not give my destiny over to another person. Are you hearing me right now? You don't understand. Some things are going to happen right now. Are you getting me now?
As you are going to pray, you pray with violence. I discovered in my working with God that it's what you permit that you admit. And it's what you admit you permanent.
Yes, sir.
Even in the realm of the spirit, they can never succumb to what you don't permit.
Yes, sir.
The devil works with what you permit.
Yes, sir.
I don't know what you permitted before now. With this key, you are going to say, Father.
I don't
say, my Father.
Holy Ghost vehicle.
Some of them are killed.
Some of them are killed.
Open your mouth and believe.
city. I am returning back with the good news. Am I talking to somebody? I am coming back with the development. I am coming back with favor. So my father, my father, don't you expect me to return back? The way I left the village, be disappointed.
Right now,
in the name of Jesus,
in the name of Jesus.
I came here with the angels of God.
Powers from the family. Power from men you marry. Power from the father's side. Power from the mother's side.
Holy Ghost!
special angels to go with me anywhere I go for this assignment you gave me. I want the angels you gave me to do a special work here now. As they open the key, what some of them will remember later is that they remember when they open the key, they don't know what happened to them later. Father, this will be their story.
Amen.
And what faithfulness is a change.
Yeah.
It's a testimony.
Yeah.
Angels that came here with me, enter inside, outside.
Yeah.
Whatever that belongs to these precious people of God, release them.
Yeah.
Any man that be holding that woman up to conceive, cut off the head of the man.
Yeah.
That man must be looking for a job who came here. Any man that be sitting on that smart job, that woman, as they open the key, let the man be summoned here.
Yeah.
Any power that be responsible for their challenges, their pains, as they open the key, let angels bring them here to this altar.
Yeah.
Angels, position yourself everywhere right now.
Yeah.
Yes, yes. Position yourself everywhere. Yes, they are taking their place before you open the key. They are taking their place right now. Yes, feel everywhere. Feel everywhere. Stand with each person. Yes, each person. Yes. Be positioned. Each person. I'm going to count off. Seven. You open the key. One. Two. Some of you will not understand what is going on right now. You only know that you open the key, but you don't know what happens. Three, four, five, six, seven.
I will give you the key of
watch out, watch out, to. 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 What were done years ago, 30 years ago, I see them just a put. You cannot.
My God.